Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from MASH, Loretta Switz, from Carter Country, Richard Paul, and Mary Wicks, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Reivers.
Hi, John. Already on there? Already up here? Song in your heart, a smile on your face?
Yeah, I've been working out. I'm ready today.
You are? Okay. Well, you were wonderful yesterday.
Wasn't he marvelous?
As you were, too.
Dissolved.
Right. Everything okay, Chuck?
Yo!
All right, let's go and say hello to Debbie Rich and Mary Jane Vesladol. Mary Jane is the current champ. She has a total of $600 to her credit. She's being challenged by Debbie Rich, who had her first round question, did quite well with it. Match three of our stars. You ready to go on, Debbie?
Yes, I am.
All right, we'll have a question for Mary Jane right after we do this for America. I am not Ed Ames.
You could have fooled me. Yeah.
Okay, Mary Jane, A is your question. This is it. Larry the Lush said,
I may drink a lot, but my wife still adores me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on.
That's a natty outfit, Gene. You look curdy.
Thank you. Natty.
Looks like an afternoon wedding outfit.
An afternoon wedding. Mary Jane.
Is that a proposal?
Larry the Lush said, I may drink a lot, but my wife still adores me. In fact, she worships the ground I blank on.
Wet on? Wet?
Oh.
I've heard of sloppy drunk.
She said wet.
I didn't hear what she said. I blanked it out. What did she say?
Tell him, Gene.
In fact, she worships the ground I wet on. That's what she said.
Oh, you wouldn't
say that, would you, Robert?
I used to be a bartender, and I know neater drunks than that.
Yes. Where did you bartend?
All over New York, all over wet ground on New York.
All right, we're ready to see your answer. Go.
Okay.
Fall!
These are the drunks I knew.
Right. Drunks fall down. Mary Jane, you never saw a drunk, did you? Hello. Oh, speaking of drunks.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Fall. Okay, Chuck.
I just broke a rule.
Oh, yeah. Why did you? What rule is that?
Lips that touch liquor will never touch mine.
Okay. I'm sorry, Chuck. Hello, Loretta.
Hello. I said fall down.
Fall down seems to be the response here, Mary Jane. Yes, Richard?
How is this staggering along?
Oh, staggering, not quite falling down drunk. Staggering drunk. Mary?
Don't try to walk, Brett. He got you drunk. Let him drag you. I always think that's a nice way to go.
Yeah.
That's not the one.
That's it.
Fall!
Fall it is. Okay.
That
would have been
good,
nifty for you if you had said fall. Debbie Rich, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Only three people play. Brett, Chuck, and Loretta. Dumb Donald is so dumb. Once he tried to blank a TV dinner. That's how dumb he is.
Oh, my God!
Debbie? Dumb Donald is so dumb, once he tried to blank a TV dinner.
Watch?
Tried to watch a TV dinner.
Very funny.
That's how dumb he is. He tried to watch a TV dinner.
I've got my glasses on now, and I can see that she's one of the more intelligent women who's ever been on this show.
Right.
Thank you.
What does that mean?
Watch!
Watch, okay.
I'm sorry, I said focus.
Tried to focus.
Focus.
That's good. That's one of the things you do to a TV set.
Focus.
Tried to focus a TV dinner.
That's a good answer.
It is a good answer.
But I said watch.
That's better because... Now, Mary Jane, you must match five to achieve a tie. However, if you match all six, you could win another game. Joe said, my new sports car is too small. I didn't realize how small it was until a tall blank stood alongside.
What on earth does that mean?
Well, just figure it out now.
Joe said, my new sports car is too... I didn't realize just how small it was until a tall blank stood... Oh, I guess.
Yes.
Oh, I've got a good one this time.
Good.
Oh, it's a good one. I'm glad I came.
All right. Hello, Mary Jane. Ready over there. Joe said, my new sports car is too small. I didn't realize how small it was until a tall blank stood alongside.
Athlete.
Athlete. Like a tall basketball player, you look out the window and all you see are knees. Yeah. I got the idea. Let's see if anybody else thought of that over here. Robert?
Well, I talk from personal experience.
A tall cop, yeah.
Tall cop.
All right, now you got to match everybody else to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Brett, we come to you.
I'm sorry, and she really is too smart for the room because, sports, I mean, I didn't put it together. I'm sorry, I said blonde.
Blonde chick. All right. Debbie wins the game. What the rest of you have? Hold up your ties there. Dog, ant, and whatever. Stand in a little blue dot there. You don't want to show us your card, Loretta. What do you have?
A tall, short person.
A tall, short person. I can understand why you didn't want to show us your card. Now, Mary Jane leaves here with a total of $600 and our best wishes.
Thank you. That's fine.
I'm always spinning her off. We'll spin a commercial or two just for you. Hurry back and see how much money Debbie wins. Now, here we go with Debbie Rich. This is her first time up here, her first shot at the really big money. Good luck, Debbie. We'll see how you do. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said you write down your best answer to this. Blank of beans. Remember, if you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular response they gave, you get $250. Then if you match the third most popular, $100. Whom do you call on for help among our stars?
Loretta.
Loretti?
Full of beans.
Full of beans.
Robert.
Can of beans.
Can of beans.
Brett.
Pot of beans. Something just came to me.
Yeah, full of beans, can of beans, and pot of beans. It's your option now to choose one of those. Or if you can think of a better one that you think would be more popular up there, give us that. What is your pleasure?
Can of beans.
You want to say can of beans? That was Richard's answer. All right, we'll find out. No, that was Robert's answer.
Yes.
Robert gave us a can of beans there. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go down at the bottom there and reveal the $100 response. Hill of beans.
That's what Charles has never amounted to.
Hill of beans.
I did. I had there.
Okay, let's go up the ladder and look at the $250 number. Full of beans. Okay, Loretta gave you that one. We're looking for a can of beans. Robert's answer, let's slide the big one. Very good. Good judgment. Attaboy, Robert. Yeah. 10 times 500 is $5,000. That's the least you can be playing for. But if you get a good lucky spin in the star wheel, you can double your money. Let's see if it happens. Give it a go. One complete revolution. Let's see if that double life stays on.
Yippee.
Come on, double. You're going to be playing with Robert, who gave you the answer. Can of beans, and that's good. Good luck to you, my dear. $5,000. Ready? Ready, Robert? All right, this is it. Blank crown, C-R-O-W-N, blank crown, blank crown. Want to look at it? Blank crown. You ready, Robert? Put it in the slot as soon as you've made up your mind. Both of you have to get on the same wavelength for her to get the $5,000. All right, now give us your response. If it matches his, we do give you the $5,000. Blank crown.
Jeweled?
Jeweled crown.
I believe that's a rather esoteric answer, but he might have thought of it, too. Let's find out. Robert, what do you say?
I thought of it, but I didn't write it, see?
I what
said
did you write?
Royal.
Royal crown, yes. Royal crown's a good answer there. Debbie, you're going to meet another player right now, so let's welcome Amy Lee Plott. Amy Lee. Where are you from, Amy Lee?
I'm from Gardena.
Gardena?
Yes.
Welcome. Thank you. Anything you want to say about Amy Lee is okay with us.
Oh, thank you. I'm very happily married to a really wonderful man.
Good.
And he works for the telephone company. And just recently, after our fourth anniversary, we found out we're expecting our first baby, so we're really excited.
Oh, well, we're very happy for you too, Amy Lee.
Thank you. And I get a lot of strange reactions from where I work. I make caskets.
You make caskets?
Yes.
What specific part of the casket do you make?
Well, any room they can use me in. I do it all now. Right now, I'm in the seamstress room, so I sew the interiors.
Uh-huh. Have you ever done any of the woodwork?
No. Mainly stuffing them.
Right. I mean, we've had many occupations, but never a casket stuffer. It's a first. A casket stuffer.
Do they have
She's
any...
She's a casket stuffer?
That's what she does.
Do you what have does any... she stuff it with?
Well, you know, she'll make all that... No, not bodies. She does the...
No, because
the...
I have a list if it was bodies.
No. She does the fabric work on it, right?
You mean yeah. Do you have any double wides?
You're not going that soon, Richard. Hang around here for a while. Good luck to both ladies. Let's begin by asking Amy Lee to make a choice here about A or B.
A, please.
It is for Amy Lee. Amy Lee, a southern name, right?
Amy Lee.
No. Amy Lee.
Sherry said, my manicurist is from China. I know she's from China because she soaked my nails in blank. Okay, Amy Lee. Sherry said, my manicurist is from China. I know she's from China because she soaked my nails in...
Tea.
Tea, of course!
Now, what was so hard about that?
I'll tell you what was hard about that.
What, you couldn't think of tea?
No.
You couldn't think of tea?
I thought of Yang Chow fried rice. I thought of sukiyaki. Duck sauce is what I
duck
thought of.
Duck sauce, yes. A very... that's the least common denominator if I've ever seen it. Love your shirt. Yes.
I started to
say... Hate your answer. Love your shirt.
I started to say things like nails, and I realized that was India and everything, and beau geste and all that stuff.
Oh, you.
And
really?
I don't know, where's my
just
mind?
Give me a rotten answer.
I've got jet lag. Oh, I'm sorry.
You don't want to show this answer?
What an act. Unbelievable acting.
Shucks. I said hot mustard.
Could have been sweet and sour. Anything like that.
You say tea. I always think of the English tea.
Tea, yes. But of course, it comes from China, doesn't it?
So unaffected. So natural.
It's so natural.
Soy sauce is another thing.
And Barbara.
Soy sauce is good. Duck sauce.
Big hand. I don't know from duck sauce really? In LA.
No, they don't. There.
Well, I'd first of all like to apologize for the top level.
Yes.
The bottom level soaked it in tea.
Okay.
Very well thought out answer. Tea.
Do you think he's got that answer too?
Excuse me?
Yes, would you like to?
Thank you. I knew that was a mistake.
Yes, go
some
ahead,
duck
Richard.
Sauce on it. It tastes
well, it was a tough choice. I was thinking either Chinese dishwashing liquid or soy sauce.
Neither of which are very good.
How about a little tea for the Lady Mary?
Well, I tell you, tea would be kind of the Chinese torture because it's hot. I went for cold soy sauce.
Soy sauce. Well, I thought it was a nifty answer, Amy Lee. Okay, you stand by for yours, Debbie. We'll get to you in a moment right now, then. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Now, the other round one question. Debbie, you ready? This is it. The lawyer said to his client...
What?
I don't think that your eyewitness is going to help you very much. He had to use a blank to find the witness chair.
I'm ready.
All right.
I'm ready to
drive. It's Chuck writing.
Yo.
Debbie, the lawyer said to his client, I don't think that your eyewitness is going to help you very much. He had to use a blank to find the witness chair.
A cane?
A cane. Okay. Now, there were two things that came to my mind here. She came up with one of the answers.
Are you Jewish? None of my business.
No.
I said cane.
Cane. What does that have to do with the answer? Anything? I'm curious.
Well, it's a wavelength.
Oh, I see.
First-generation Americans sometimes get
really?
On.
Really?
Yes.
Very interesting. How about you?
No, I'm not Jewish. I was married to a Jewish person once.
You learned your lesson.
Yes, that's right. No, I say a cane and a...
Okay.
Cane.
Cane. Three for Debbie. They came up with one of the two good possibilities.
Yes, I thought of Cain.
And you rejected it?
No, I thought that could... Maybe he was lame.
Oh. But,
so I said seeing eye dog.
Seeing eye dog?
Which really was very specific that he couldn't... Never mind.
Okay. That is the other good possibility that I was thinking of. Cain or seeing eye dog.
Loretta and I have been hanging around the pet store, so we had the same name.
Seeing eye dog, yeah. Yes. Okay, Mary, animal lover that you are.
Yeah, indeed. And I didn't think a cane would take him directly to the witness chair. It's a seeing eye dog.
Seeing eye dog. So we had three of those and three of the others there. Evenly divided. All right. Now we go to round two. Amy Lee, A or B?
B this time, please.
B? Okay. One person does not play. That's Loretta. Here it is. Yeah. Matilda is a really rotten cook. Uh-oh. Now, her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank. Really,
the hell
rotten.
Writing
cook.
These answers, or is it me?
You think that's a rotten one?
No, I seem to find them very.
Matilda is a really
difficult.
Rotten cook. Her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank.
Oh,
I'm through already.
Oh,
I just was straining at the leash there, and
he got right to it.
Right to it.
Now let me just take a little peek there, see what you got right there. Very.
I never match. They sound good, though.
Yeah, that's
match.
A good answer. Her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank. Okay?
Drawing.
Frozen dinner.
Frozen dinner. And I'm not going to help him because he's never helped me once this week, and I've been in terrible trouble a lot of times, and he's been of no assistance whatsoever, and he says, look at her, America, look at her.
The operative word is, wait a minute, you need a little help here to search your memory?
I got it.
You got it, okay. I won't give you any help. All right.
Beat your heart out.
What's the matter with the upper tier today?
I don't know. Here we go with Amy Lee. Matilda's a really rotten cook. Her idea of a frozen dinner is a blank.
Popsicle.
Popsicle. That's not a bad answer, Amy Lee. Popsicle is okay, because it's frozen.
Are you Jewish?
No.
I said popsicle.
Oh! Okay.
I said a ice cube.
A ice cube is good. Popsicle is good.
I said cracked ice on toast points.
Cracked ice on toast points. Okay, 3-2 the score now. Loretta does not play. We come to Richard.
I think Brett's getting smarter all along.
She is.
Ice cube.
Now, you must match Mary to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Amy Lee, what have you got there?
I've got ice French fried with ketchup.
Ice, all right. So, Debbie wins another game. Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
I'm going to send you a whole mountain of gifts.
Oh,
Amy
you.
Lee Clock, ladies and gentlemen. Let's spin her off and spin a message for America.
Help.
Huh? Caught me.
Killer, no,
I'm just walking up and down here. I'm
why
picketing the upper tier.
Why are you picketing us?
Well, you take too much time to write down your answers.
I'm not. We don't
take
too
much time. Upper tier, unfair to the lower
but
tier.
But we're right most of the time. Well,
who got ice dizzy. Cube and who got...
Popsicle.
Okay, I'm calling off the strike. Okay,
I have a heavy thing to say.
Yes, go ahead, Chuck.
I get a lot of mail, and some of it is highly insultive.
Really?
Yes, insulting.
Yes.
And I don't mind that at all.
Yeah.
But please, especially the woman who has the San Francisco trolley stationery, Be kind enough, whoever you are that insults me, to put your name and address so I can retort. Because if you don't, then it's really not an insult at all. It's like a cop-out.
Right.
Is that too dramatic to end the day with?
I think it is. Don't send him your address. Let he'll send some muscle after
I could read you some of those letters.
Yeah. Well, can we find out where
let
she
those
got
those who live in glass trolleys, right?
That's right.
I never heard of anybody asking for insults like that.
Now let's stop this all nonsense and all get together here and have a good time again tomorrow.
Dun, 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 dun.
Good Gene Mabry here. Goodbye, Mets game 78.
Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tupman production. The program is edited for broadcast.